Hello and welcome back to Advanced Rocketry. In the last episode we built some rockets, or perhaps only one, but that was for traveling ourselves. Today we are building a new rocket, but this time we're launching satellites into orbit, and so we'll go through how to do that and different types of data. Only three types of data collection. And then we'll go through how to transfer and save and distribute the data. So everything begins with the same as before. You have a launch pad and you have rocket assembling machine that is exactly the same. So let's build a rocket, perhaps something like this. Probably bigger than we need to. And then on top, we put a satellite bay. So let's jump up and do that. And I know this is, well, we can scan it, it's quick. And that's everything you need for the rocket itself. We can see the thrust and weight and fuel and everything. So let's build it. This is okay for satellites. So the next part is, well, we need a satellite builder. It's a quite advanced machine. You need a lot of stuff to do this. And in this a bit terrifying GUI, we have a few things to go through. First of all the components. So you put all your components in the satellite builder and you build it like we did with the rocket, but only in the machine. Now if we shift right click here, we can same as before with a normal rocket, we click the satellite bay and you know the guidance computer from before. Here's the satellite bay instead, and this is where you put the satellite. So let's craft the satellite. First of all, you need satellite ID chip. Nothing hard with that. So I have a few in stock already. You need some way to gather power up there, solar panels. You can either go with the basic one or the advanced or the large solar panel. In this satellite we'll build now, I will use the large one. And then there are three types of data collection you can do currently. So optical sensor, composition sensor, and mass detector. I have a few of each in stock, so we shouldn't be. I will only build one or two rockets, but the principle is the same. Then we have some energy collection and ore mapping and stuff, but we won't go through that today. And then we need something called a storage unit. This one is crafted in the precision assembler, but it's not too hard to make. And then the satellite itself. When you craft it, it's empty, but you use the satellite builder to assemble it. So this is how you do it. Satellite, the empty one up here. We need a satellite ID chip. And then we need some way to store the data. Down here we have one of each data storage unit in these slots. And let's go with two solar panels and one battery, or a double battery. You can mix these, but I haven't really figured out or investigated what the best setup is. So but this works for now. It's what I've used so far, but perhaps you can make a smarter and more optimal build. Then we have only one slot left, and this up here. This is what determines the type of satellite you're sending up. And these sensors, the one that we crafted over here, you select one and then that's the type of satellite you'll have. So if I place an optical sensor up here, this satellite will gather distance data. So let's build it and see how it looks. It's a quick build. Then you get two things. The empty satellite chip, the unprogrammed that we had before, is now programmed. This one has ID 16, and that's because I have quite a few from before, and they just add in number. It says optical telescope, and that's because we have the optical sensor. And this is the satellite itself. Power generation, data storage, great. Now we shift right click the rocket, go into the satellite bay, and we place the satellite in here. So now we are pretty much ready to go. You need to fuel it like you normally do. Let's sheet in some more rocket fuel, and it seems to be, yep, it's filled up already. So this rocket is finished. Before I send it, I'll just go through one final detail in the satellite builder, and that's this button, right to secondary ship. So if I take this ID ship, the one that we just crafted, and then we place an unprogrammed in this slot and we write to secondary, we'll make a copy of the ID chip. So now we'll have two identical chips. Can be good to have in case you lose them or something blows up, goes wrong, whatever. I will keep these at least in this tutorial world, but I actually don't know how often you need to make a copy. But the thing is, if you lose them, the satellite up there is unreachable. So just keep that in mind. And then, as I said before, this it's very similar to the normal rocket, but it has only the satellite bay on top. In this one, we have the seat and everything, so we can sit in it. We can't right-click this. So we can't launch it like we did here, you know, press space to take off. We have to use something called rocket monitoring station. You need, this one is your control unit, so to say, when you're not in the rocket. So if I place it here, it has power connected to everything. I think you also link it. You program the linker. Yeah, I think you program it, link it with the rocket assembling machine, which is connected to the rocket. So everything here is connected together. This one was already linked to this launch pad and everything. Now here we have two choices. We can either launch it manually or we can redstone control it. And this can be done, for example, with the fueling station. It can output a redstone signal when it's done. And this that could launch the rocket automatically, for example. But we're filled with fuel and we have the satellite in there. So let's launch it and well, there it goes. And we can keep a track of it here. Velocity going in max speed now and altitude is rising. So when it comes up here, it's in space, basically. Probably in orbit around Earth, I guess. And then we can connect with it. Just one word before we move on. The rocket, what's up with that? Well, sometimes I get it back. I think you're supposed to get it back, and they end up coming down pretty much where they want to. Hopefully somewhere near. I have two over here, but I haven't looked that far away, but you might get them back. So I'll stop that, and so I won't say too much but that's how it is. And now it's up. We don't have any connection with it, or perhaps it's come back already, but either way, it's time to take a look at the data and connect to the satellite. To do that, we need the satellite terminal right over here. Nothing too strange. And we simply take our satellite ID chip and put it in this slot. Now this interface tells us that we have connected to this satellite. If I have a different satellite ID chip, we will have a different satellite here. So now if I am connected to it, we can see that the distance data that we gathered, this was an optical sensor, so it gathers distance data. It's now connected and it's storing this data in a terminal, right now in the buffer, but we can also use the data storage units and store it to chip. And then these can be extracted, and as you can see, we have 8 distance data on the chip, so we can move wherever we want with this USB-like stick. And then we do exactly the same with... let me try to build as small as possible. We do the same thing if we're going for a composition or mass. We just get a different chip that says mass scanner, composition scanner, and so on. Not enough fuel. All right, let's go for one more. I think that's good. Build. And quickly, just so you remember, satellite, and then we can put the, the type of satellite up here, mass detector in this case. Some data, we have solar panels, battery, ID chip, and then build. So it's quite easy, quite fast. Then we get the mass scanner satellite, and just for good measures, write to a secondary chip as well. Insert the satellite in here, in the satellite bay. It's already fueled and ready. Now we have 2 of these chips, so I can put one over here. And this is ready to go, so let's launch that as well. So it's quite quick to launch a satellite rocket, but hopefully you'll get the rocket back. I can't see it right now, but well, you can try for yourself. And then this one is collecting, we have, let's see, with 19 distance data. Good stuff. Now if we place the next satellite up here, it's not done yet. We're not in orbit, but it should, yep, done. And we're connected, mass scanner. So pretty much what we expected. Now, what can we do with these? Now we have distance data, and let's say we have some distance, mass, and composition data. What to use them for? Well, I will go more into this in the next episode, I think. And before we leave today, I want to mention the Astrobody data processor. It's in the holo projector. Let's see. Astrobody data processor. Hatches, power, something called a data bus, and stone slabs, and then the processor itself. So it's quite simple to build. I have it over here. Nothing too strange here either. Precision assembler. Yeah, you need the basic stuff. And then to transfer the, we still use the satellite terminal, but in this one we transfer the different types of data to these data buses, and they will show up like this. So you can see here I have a few. I gathered some already. These have, so I can store to buffer, I can fill them like this, or I can move between the data storage units or internally in the machine. You can also see them from back here. So still it's only mass, composition, and distance data. I'm not doing anything with it right just yet, but we'll do that next episode. So you can either use the data storage units to just simply put them here and store to chip or buffer, or you can use something very new. I think this is just in the latest version of the mod. Wireless transceiver. So use data storage units, and we get a few of these, and then to transfer you need to use the linker. So you simply shift right click and shift right click again. In this one I will have it put on extract and activate, and here we have well, we're not extracting, so we're inserting, and this is also turned on. So this optical telescope, it gives us distance data. It's we have nothing in this buffer, so probably 1191. It was just 90, so this one is transferring the distance data directly into the astrobody data processor. You have the same system in the observatory, where we also need data. We'll talk about this in the next episode, I think. You used to have something called a data cable. I think it still works if you have it already in the mod and it's updated, but I haven't covered so far, so I won't go through it. You used to use that like a cable and just connect it, but now it's the transceiver, so it's wireless, and well, that's a bit easier, I guess. So eventually it might look something like this, that you have different terminals. I have three here, one for each. This one is for, let's see, composition, optical, and mass. And they are, all of them are in extract mode, sending over here to receive it into this astrobody data processor. So here we're constantly filling up. So yeah, I think that's pretty much it. At least you know now how to send things, satellites up in space, in orbit, and how to collect data and how to transfer data between the satellite terminal and whatever you want to use it in. But more on that in next episode, I think. I hope I see you then. Take care, and bye-bye.